All right, Jeff Zimmerman here with the champ, the legend, Andre Ward, HOF, SOG.
What's up, buddy?
Here in Dallas, just wrote a book, out here for a book signing. How was it, Andre?
Man, it was great, man. A lot of love from Dallas and the surrounding area. A lot of people showing love and great feedback. And it makes it all worth it, you know?
Why the title, Killing the Image?
I told on myself in the book. Mm-hmm. Nah, it's, you know, when you start talking about your life, man, and kind of pulling back the covers, like, it's going to kill some images that people may have of you. And that may mean that, you know, it may make them even more of a supporter. And I got a lot of that today, too. Like, man, I was rocking with you before this, but, man, I really support you now. So it's just going to probably tear down certain perceptions that people may have that, oh, he hasn't been through that. You know, he's never been through nothing like that. So, but that's the whole point, man, is to go through that process, talk about it. It was like therapy writing the book, and it's like therapy getting the feedback about the book and seeing the impact that it's having on people.
2004 Olympic gold medalist, undefeated as a pro, Hall of Famer. I mean, you've done stuff that nobody has done, but yet you always seem like the underdog still. Mm. You know, was that the mentality throughout your whole career?
That's just my lane, man. You know, it's like I got a lot of love and a lot of support, but, you know, you're going to always have people doubting. You're going to always have people trying to minimize you and marginalize you. And, you know, I'm human, so I hear it and I see it, but, like, I've been in the game a long time, man. That stuff don't move me no more. You know, like, I'm not trying to prove anything to anybody. You know, my theme for when I got inducted into the Hall of Fame is the debate is over. So, you see people still, you know, typing stuff and making comments. And, you know, I say, man, do that until your fingers bleed, man. It ain't going to change nothing. I'm etched in history. And, you know, whether you like it or not, that's what it is. So, that's what I focus on, man. And somebody got to represent the underdog. So, I'm cool to do it.
Hey, I know you said you're done. But you and Canelo have been doing some verbal sparring. You're on the Breakfast Club, questioning his resume a little bit, not the first time, and, you know, he thinks you're jealous and all that. I mean, $150-200 million from Saudi, Andre Ward back in the ring against Canelo for a super fight.
Well, first of all, I'm gonna just say he's never called my name. You know, he's had plenty of opportunities to call my name, and one specific opportunity is after he fought over there. So that's not something he wants to do. All the stuff about, you know, payday and this and that, you can use that toward the mother guys. That don't fit for me. So it may sound good, your fans are around with it, they get some headlines, but it's a lot. You know, you don't know what I got in my bank account. You know, you don't know what I got, what I don't have. And you're not gonna get me to stop speaking about something that's true because you're mad about it. And I don't think he realizes that shows a lot of mental weakness, man, when that's your first reaction. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So if Mike Tyson says something about you that you don't like, you gotta be able to sit up under that and either take it or have a response that warrants what's being said about you. But the first thing he does is go try to attack Mike Tyson. It's like, bro, there's videos of you inebriated around the internet. So I don't stand for that stuff, man. Nobody's gonna silence me in this sport, a fan base, a fighter. And if I'm asked about something or if I'm going to bring something up, I'm going to talk about it. Qualified to talk about it. It's facts. And you're not going to move me off my mark because you accuse me of hating somebody. I don't hate. You can't make me hate nobody. But what people don't talk about when I speak about Canelo is the credit I give. In the Breakfast Club interview, the same interview I just did, I said, hey, man, if I'm really about a payday and I'm really trying to get a fight with you, why would I tell the host, hey, man, all this stuff about Canelo ducking me, that's not true. Me and him never had history. We only had a common. Why would I say that? So that stuff don't work with me. That may work with somebody that's like chasing a fight with you. I ain't chasing no fight with Canelo. I'm thinking about Canelo like that. But I'm also not going to be silenced and censored because his fans don't want to hear the truth about it. And here go the thing, bro. Like, this ain't just me talking about this. Any other fighter would ask for $150 million or $200 million to fight somebody. What you think would be said if Floyd did that? Terrence did that. Or so anybody did that. So you don't get no pass because you Canelo. you're going to be called out like everybody else, whether you like it or not.
Will this be a stain on his career if he doesn't fight Benavidez?
Listen, man, it's not just the Benavidez thing. It's been happening throughout his career, you know? And I have always, I'm not, like, you know the thing, bro. Like, I can walk and chew gum at the same time. I've been commentating a long time. I've been speaking out about things, and I don't speak out about a lot of things that I see. So I'm not trying to garner headlines. No, I'm just not. It's not easy. I could say something reckless right now and blow up the internet. It's not what I'm trying to do. But if it's something that needs to be spoken about or somebody asks me about something, I'm gonna talk about it. And his fans won't say it's a stain on his legacy, and I don't think it's a problem with Canelo handpicking his opponents to try to make the most money and minimize the risk. I'm not, like, that's not the problem. The only issue is when people, when you start saying you're one of the greatest of all time, or when you're one of the greatest Mexican fighters of all time. No, you a great marketer. You've sold a lot of tickets. You have a fan base. When it comes to what's being done in this ring, you start talking about legacy, bro. You got to take risks. And you shouldn't take risk. You shouldn't take risk every fight out. You need to have some gimme fights. But when you start looking at the history, it's like, man, you picked him because he old. Man, you picked him because he's been on for 2 years. Man, you picked him because he's two weight classes smaller. Man, you got to call out about that stuff. I don't care who you are.
Hey, champ, welcome to Dallas, man. This is J.J. Solomon.
What's up,
Spit Bucket? Spit Bucket Podcast. We appreciate you being here, man.
Yes, sir.
Big congrats on the book release.
Thank you.
Just one quick question. We got local news going crazy with the Errol Spence, Derek James, reportedly rumors that they're split up. What are your thoughts on that? If the rumors are true, where does Errol land? Is this a good or bad move for Spence?
I can't really speak on that because I don't know what they got going on, you know. I just wish them both the best. And I rock with Derek. I rock with Errol. I really like Errol. You know, I've been cool with Errol for years. I just want the best for both of them, man. I hate to hear it if it's true. You know, you want to see people ride it out, especially people that's been you know, that close for that long, ride it out to the end, even when they hit rough waters. But it's not always a reality. So, man, I just wish them both the best.
Good. And then just one quick question on the 135, 140, huge talent pool. Obviously, you've got the Haney, Shakur, Tank, Teofimo, but I've said for the longest time that the gap between the champs and the contenders in that range is not that big. Who do you think, obviously we know you got your big on Shakur, but 10, 15 years from now, who are we talking about as the king of that weight range?
They got to fight. They got to fight, they got to mix it up, and they got to fight. Because it's just all speculation. And it, you know, it's a place for that, right? Get on the podcast, get on the show, and say, man, I think this guy's going to win. I think that guy's going to win. They got to fight. Because they all are talented. They all got different assets and weaknesses. They got to fight. They got to fight.
Facts.
What about Canelo Munguia, Andre? Do you like that fight?
I mean, it's a fight. I like Munguia. You know, I followed Munguia when I was at HBO. I think right when I retired or right before I retired. And Munguia's a tough fight. It's a cool fight.
And Terrence, one last question. Terrence, I know he's your guy. He wants that fight with Canelo. Since you're not going to come out of retirement, is he the guy to take him down?
I don't think he's going to take it, bro. And the excuses for not taking it don't make sense. He's too small, won't get credit. But you can say that when you fought Amir Khan. So we just got to look, bro. We got to be consistent with what we say. And all the insults and all the lies and stuff, that stuff ain't going to move me, man. I've been in this, like I said, I've been in the hot seat a long time. You got to do better than that. I'm not worried about that. I'm going to still... All that don't disqualify me. That qualifies me. When people react like that, at least you know that you're touching on a nerve. So.
Andre, thanks for coming out, man.
Hey,